We spoke about this last year. A lot of you actually did say that you completely and absolutely agree, and many of you woke up to these amazing facts and data that our relationship, our deep embedded relationship with our phone is completely and totally spoiling. And if not spoiling, dramatically changing the way we actually have a relationship with other human beings. Your own family, your own friends, people that are in your house, outside your house. And now in the time of the pandemic, in the times of the lockdown, things changed even more. We've both been really, really taking a huge step forward in trying to make all of us understand how our relationship with our phone is changing our human relationships. So let's first take a look at that story.
With smartphones at the center of our connected lives, their impact on our social interactions, activities, behavior, and everyday connections cannot be overstated. Increasing smartphone use has never been more amplified as in the post-COVID and lockdown era. A new study published by Vivo titled Smartphones and Their Impact on Human Relationships 2020 quantifies this data and gives us better insights into how increased smartphone usage is triggering addiction among users. Some of the key highlights from the report suggest that smartphone usage has gone up by at least 25% in the post-COVID era, with 84% users checking their phones within 15 minutes of waking up. Additionally, 89% of users agree that smartphone dependence is having an impact on the quality of time they spend with family. The study commissioned by Vivo and conducted by Cyber Media Research further suggests that over 70% of users feel that smartphone usage is having an adverse impact on their mental and physical health. This is further corroborated by evidence suggesting that users feel moody and irritable without access to their smartphones. In fact, 74% of users admitted to feeling isolated without access to their phones. While smartphones have been the key lifeline to keeping friends and family connected during lockdowns, this increased dependence shows clear signs of addictive behavior. Of the 2,000 people interviewed for the report, 73% agreed that they would feel much happier if they could choose to switch off their phone periodically, a sharp contrast over the 57% who agreed to the same last year. So if you are getting the feeling that your smartphone is taking over your life, using tools like digital well-being would be a good way to start tracking your usage patterns.
And now let's talk to Nipun Maurya, of course, the man behind all of this with Vivo. Nipun, thank you so much.
Thank you, Rajiv. Thank you so much for having me on the show.
You did this last year and congratulations. You're carrying this forward, a phone company that actually is making people aware that you shouldn't be spending so much of unhealthy time on your phone. So great initiative. But first, I must start by congratulating you. 6 years completed here in India.
As far as the Vivo in India is concerned, it's been a great journey for us. 6 years, and we still believe we've only just begun.
So Nipun, you know, the first question to do with this entire study that you did and such startling facts that came out of this study, we just presented some of that data to all our audience. How did you come up with this idea? Kind of difficult to understand why a phone company would want to tell people not to really use their phones as much as we all are.
Interesting question, Rajiv. Yes, it seems counterintuitive that a smartphone brand is telling its users not to use, you know, too much of smartphones. See, the reason for that is we believe, you know, we at Vivo, we are in the business of smartphones, but there is a larger brand purpose why Vivo exists. And this larger brand purpose is to spread joy, you know, amongst all the key stakeholders that we have. And one of the most important stakeholders we have are our consumers. That, you know, too much of technology use is going against the larger brand purpose we have.
So Nipun, you know, like I said, startling facts came out of it, how 25% more usage. I mean, already we were at an incredible, incredible state of using our phones. And now even 25% increase in that is an incredible one. Can you tell us some more findings that you actually came about?
I was certainly expecting there will be increased usage, but nowhere. Never did I expect that there will be a 39% increase in usage from 2019 to today. And that's what we've seen. From nearly 5 hours daily usage of smartphones in 2019, we are now looking at a nearly 7 hours of phone usage daily. As people wake up, in the first 15 minutes last year, around 52% people used to check their phone within the first 15 minutes of waking up. This number has now increased to 88%. which means there are only 12% people who are not checking their phone in the first 15 minutes of waking up.